Welcome back to Why in the Morning. And if it's Tuesday, it's Entrepreneurship Tuesday at Y254 channel. Is where you can find us across all our social media handles. At Michelle Ashira is where you can find me across all my social. So in this next interview, we're looking into, our topic is the entrepreneurship journey. And my guest today is none other than Immaculate Muruge, aka Ashley. Hi, Ashley.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good.
You know this face, most people will be looking at you and be like, this face is so familiar. Where did I see you, Ashley? Introduce yourself. Ambia watu nafanyanga nini?
Okay. So my real name is Immaculate Muruge, but most people don't know me as Immaculate. They call me Ashley because I used to act in Tidy High for 9 years. So that name really stuck. So I took it as my brand name. So I call myself Ashley Muruge. So everywhere I go, it's like, Ashley, hi, you. So what do? I work for government. I work for Embu County Government as the Deputy Director of the Governor's Press and Public Communication. I also do productions. So I'm a film producer. I've done like 2 films, produced like 2 short films in Embu. Also a PR and communication consultant. So that's basically what I do.
Okay. It's been a journey, yeah? From being an actress to now being behind the scene, a producer, and now you're working for the county government. So let's take us through what you're doing. You have your own company, actually.
Yes, I do.
So how did it all start for you to get into, like, you know, business?
So this is how it started. I started working when I was 19 years. I actually started hooking in Embu. I used to hook spoons, and I used to earn like 15 shillings per dozen of spoons. So I was really good at my craft, just smiling at watu kwa shamba, and mom, then we came for a training in Nairobi. And when I came to Nairobi, I called one of my aunties and I told her, hey, I'm not going back to Embu. Just get me any job. I was 19. I will do it. She told me, okay, sawa, kuja, let's talk. She got me a job in a certain hospital as a receptionist, to work there for like a month. Then my mom hooked me up with her friend who gave me a job in a certain studio. I was still 19. My results had not yet come out. So this is at the studio is when I actually learned that my passion for photography, videography, and customer service. You know, I was dealing with the CEOs, I was dealing with board directors, I was dealing with everyone from all walks of life. And I was like, wow. And everyone who used to come at the studio was like, I want to be whatever by Muruge. They used to call me Muruge at that particular time, to be served by Muruge. So I really, really, really worked hard and I really loved what I used to do. And by the time my results were coming out, I knew exactly what I wanted to do. I wanted to be in the media space. And that's how I went and did mass communication for my diploma level. Rised up, got my gig at Tidy High when I was 21 years old. They advertised for a new class. I applied, got the job. 9 years down the line, I used to do Tidy High of the weekends or when Nairobi Academy Funga School. Still worked at the studio. I was still in class. I know.
Take a slap.
I was a hustler.
Okay. Just before we even go ahead, now you're in Tidy High. Allow me to take you back. So at 19, you already, you know, hooking spoons. You were working in a studio. Why were you so determined? What kept you pushing like that?
This is what happened. We went into a downgrade, the family. So my mom used to have a very good job. She used to work with the United Nations. So I used to be in Kilimani Primary. Like, our life was literally really, really good.
Cool kids.
We were cool kids, my friend. Cool kids. So when I was like in class 7, something happened. Like, my mom got back together with my dad. That was a very toxic relationship right there. It really affected my mom and me and my brother. And by the time he was passing on, we had to go back to Shags because it really affected even how my mom, because she was the one who used to do everything for us, pay school fees, everything, literally everything. So she was stressed, so we had to go back to Shags. We went to live in Embu and we was in school in Embu. Now tell me, a kid from a cool kid to now ushago mtuataju kusema niata is high in Kiembu. We had to learn that.
And in most cases, it could be in that scenario, most people will shy away, especially like because you're you know, you're used to a certain lifestyle. Yeah. Now things are not the same. So people shy away. So what made you so, very brave to just decide that I'm going to do A, B, C, D, and D. I'm going to look for a job. I'm going to work in a studio. So why?
All through my class 7 to form 4, I never used to think about anything else. I just wanted out. My aim was just to work hard, really hard. And even after my high school levels, nimalize, I make my mom comfortable. That was my drive. I wanted my mom to go back to where she was. She used to be very pretty. You know, she was she used to be the secretary, one of the secretaries of Kofi Annan.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to make her be there again. Mm-hmm. So that was my drive, and that's why I started working when I was 19. Mm-hmm. All through like that. And I can say it's been good. So one day when I was at the studio, mm-hmm. I was the main photographer for the MD of Kenya Re, because the studio was downstairs. And when I went to take a photo, the corporate affairs manager was like, Ashley, that shirt that you're wearing, this is what we've been looking for, mm-hmm. for our staff. I asked her how many. She told me 500 pieces. I was like, what? Is this the dream? This is how I'm going to go back to uni. But because I really wanted to go to Daystar, because it's the best university in terms of PR and communication. Okay. But because I had really learned that craft of dealing with people, rejection,
working
the studio, production. I was an actress behind the camera and in front of the camera, mm-hmm. and now PR. So I got the job. It was really vigorous.
Okay. So here you are. Someone has approached you. They've seen a shot that they actually liked, and you were like, "Yo, I can actually, you know, produce the 500 you guys want."
Yeah.
At this particular point, how come you're thinking real quick like this? What was inside you? Like, did you have a plan? Did you have like a company registered already? Did you know someone who could actually make this happen?
I actually had a company that had registered when I was 22. That Solutions Media Productions, which I used to do gigs like photography and videography of the weekend, like shoot weddings, kidogo birthday parties and all that. Never serious. It was just like, so you can do this. Because that time my ex used to tell me, hey, and you've been away to Maliza Shule, we are looking for a job, but you can't get, why not create our own jobs?
Okay. For most young people, when they get probably their money through their hustle, they think about partying for the next weekend, you know. So what made you decide that, you know, I'm going to, you know, open up my own company?
Because of the experience that I had, mm-hmm. And because we used to look for a job with my ex-boyfriend at that particular time, and we never used to get a job.
Okay.
We used to really look for a decent job, like in a bank, we just sat down one day and we were like, hey, why can't we create our own job? We are good at what we do. You have your experience in IT. I have my experience in photography, videography, and whatnot. Let's start a company. At that particular time, registering a company was 800 bob at Sharia House. That's what we did.
Okay.
And after that, a client will come, hey, Ashley, so can you do this for me? I was like, yeah, I can do this for you. Sawa, ka 80,000 coming here, enye? I used to earn, I think, 20,000 in the studio. Mm-hmm. That was maybe like a 40,000 extra that will keep me going, you know, dress up nicely, go for meetings, go to class. You know, also the pressure of you have friends who are being paid school fees by their parents. You're paying. I started paying for my own school fees when I was 20 in college.
Mm-hmm.
My degree all through Daystar University, four and a half years, I've paid for my own school fees because of my company. Like, I wasn't employed.
Okay.
So after the Kenya Re gig, I got a tender of 1.35 million, and that's how I actually went back to school. And through that, I actually learned, I got good suppliers. I was good at my craft in terms of PR and comms. And I was like, wow, I can actually do this. I don't have to be employed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, okay, actually, so you actually started a business.
Yeah.
I was about to say passion, and then I remembered what Njiku said earlier about it's all about putting yourself out there and suffering and all that. But here you are starting a company, starting in a lane of a business, which you have not gone to school for, but you know, out of love and out of experience, you are so determined to do this. So how did you build your business skills when handling your clientele at this particular time?
Trust me, it wasn't that easy, because you're young and you're talking on phone like a grown-up and everything. They're like, oh, you I've been referred to you by a certain client. You're the one who did that. I was like, yeah. So when I go to meet this client, the client looks at me like, Are you sure you're the one? Because I was so young. I was like 24, 25. And this is maybe a deal of 1 million or 800,000. I was like, madam, I am the one. And I'm going to deliver. So I used to face a lot of, because you're young, you can't handle
this.
So
they questioned your credibility.
Yeah, your credibility. Mm-hmm. But now through time, I had to prove myself. I really had to really work hard, do many samples, do a lot of meetings with them, and show them that I can actually do it. Mm. Yeah.
Okay. Mm. Wow. At that particular age, and you're negotiating millions. So take me through, how did you position yourself, like in brand positioning? How did you position yourself in a state whereby you can actually negotiate for this particular kind of deals and actually be able to deliver as a brand?
Yeah. Mm. So I came to realize, so I was actually just doing this just for fun or something like that, just to make money so that I can go to school and all that. So I had to look for an expert. I needed a logo. I need a logo origination. I needed a website. I needed social media handles for my company, for myself. I knew exactly what I wanted to do. Anything that, even if I'm partying, I wouldn't post photos because the internet never forgets. Mm-hmm. So I'm really keen in what I post. I just don't post anything because there's a way I want people to
perceive,
because that is actually me. Many people out here, they really fake it. But how do you want people to perceive you? How do you want people to know you? Right? So I used to post a lot of what I'm doing at that particular time, and someone will actually inbox me and tell me, I'm looking for someone who can do it. And also the Tidy High thing really assisted me, because everyone was like, Ashley, enye uko na vituko na mama yako hapa kwa TV. Ebu, imagine this is Ashley. And then I take advantage, but this is what I do. Mm-hmm. They used to give me a lot of business because of that familiarity. So most of my clients used to like working with me because of the familiarity, mm-hmm. and also the professionalism that I'll actually bring on the table.
All right, apart from referrals, what other marketing strategies did you use?
I used to do a lot of walk-ins. That time, social media wasn't all that, hyped like now because of COVID. Everyone is taking their business online. I used to do a lot of walk-ins. I could actually, me and my business partner, we could walk with her. Like, we would look at a building that is empty, and we would just walk into each and every office from top floor down, telling them, so you don't have a signage, yeah? You don't have wall branding. We can do this for you. How much do you cost? We just be mine, tell them. So that's how we used to do it. Mm-hmm. And just making a lot of calls. And most of my clients actually started coming after referrals. Mm-hmm. After I used to do a lot of trainings, I went for Centonomy. I did Centonomy Entrepreneur. I learned that I actually need to focus on my strength.
What is Centonomy Entrepreneur?
Well, Shekendwati, she's the owner of Centonomy Entrepreneur.
All about financial management.
Financial management and also the entrepreneurship side of it.
Okay.
Yeah. I just started positioning myself with people, like-minded people, and also started getting mentors who are either in the same field or people who I know I can ask, what do I need to do so that I can continue doing it?
Okay.
Yeah.
Let me tell you, listening to your story, it sounds so perfect. Like, things are just aligning themselves for your sake. So what are a couple of challenges that you faced along the way?
Being a young person.
Before we get into you working for the county government.
I'm actually, now, whatever it's there. So that, like, I got my county job immediately after I cleared Kampo, which was, I was 28 years old. Mm-hmm. And this is the thing. I look at opportunities and I walk in. I walk in and come and ask you, hey, so this is what I actually think I can do, right? Let me go back to the kind of deals that I used to get, the tenders and all that.
Okay.
The youth usually say that the government usually don't assist them. To be honest, me, I'll say I've really been assisted by GAVA, by the way, from the time I was 24 years old. Mm-hmm. My LPO financing, I used to get them from Youth Fund. And this is because I used to watch the news and all the marketing and PR, whatever they used to do. And I'd used to walk into the office and ask them, so this is what I actually saw in the TV. Is it actually true? Are you guys giving LPO financing?
Mm-hmm.
So I have a tender from Kenya Re Insurance Plaza,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
and it's for this amount of money. My bank has
bank
statement wasn't looking good at all.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, can you give me? And they're like, yeah. And I'm like, what? Paku na shtuka. Within 2 weeks, they could, transfer the money na supply client wangu. wanapata pesa yao, they give me my profit. Again, they have another product called Talanta product. So they used to sit me down, and I remember that time, especially that time Catherine Amuye, who died, was the CEO at that particular time. That lady really sat me down, like, because she used to see a lot of passion in me and actually really wanted to do what I had to do. Because I could see an opportunity. That time Uhuru, the president, had just said that the youth need to take advantage mm-hmm. of the 30%.
Okay.
So I took advantage of that, the mm-hmm. AGPU. That time you couldn't even
for
apply online.
For the youth
online.
And disability.
Yes, okay. The youth, women, and persons with disability. I had that certificate, and actually that is actually really assisted me to get to school, because I used to work with parastatals, KEMSA, okay. Kenya Re, whatnot, you get, mm-hmm. because of that. I just used to walk in and ask. What is lacking with our youth nowadays, because there's a lot of backlash, oh, the government is not helping me, oh, nini, nini. But it's up to you to walk in, go and ask for these opportunities, and be very consistent and resilient. Right.
Okay, so for someone who is watching this conversation and they've been part of the group whereby they believe that, you know, these opportunities that they say it's for the youth, they're just saying it for the display, but it's not actually happening.
Yeah.
What would be your advice?
My advice is just continue, just walk in, go and ask. Mm-hmm. But again, it's true that what you're asking, because sometimes the time when Catherine passed on, there was an ECU then, and I was trying to process some money there, and they were becoming very difficult. And I told them, I've actually done this before. What is different right now? And you're making a lot of noise out here in universities, telling them you don't need to be employed. Just take advantage of youth fund. We're going to give you this money. And I actually asked the former chairman, Ronnie, and asked him, why are you telling the youth this? And to be honest, I was just in your office the other time and was talking to your credit manager, and he was telling me there's no money, you get. So I could see a lot of youth come to me and tell me, "Baby, Ashley, you're right. This is what has been happening. The youth, they have the skills, they have their companies, but they just need that support from the old folks. I work for county government. Mm-hmm. A lot of challenges that I'm actually even facing right now, it's because of being young, because that adopting, they don't want to adopt what is happening right now. And I think that is actually the problem. But we just have to do what we have to do, my friend.
We got to do what we got to do. Yeah. So how can we curb that challenge whereby, I'm so sure we have a couple of also other young entrepreneurs who are working with the government, and they feel like, you know, like they always have to do an extra mile just to prove themselves, and yet they are credible.
Yeah.
So what's your take on that?
My take, just maybe this people who are here at the middle, because the bosses are actually really good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the bosses, the top notch, but the president, the whatnot, they are really good. They know exactly what they want. The governors, they know exactly what they want. And when they put you in that position, they expect you to deliver.
Mm-hmm.
But now, if you're in a situation where you can't deliver because of some people, or because of maybe finances, or because of my youth wanataka kushikiliwa tu mkono, and they will actually let them be like your peers. They'll actually show you the way, because they are the ones who are fresh from school. They are the ones who have been taught the new curriculum. As in, we need to change, even as a country, and that's why we are not going forward, because our shikiliwi mikono. Because these old folks, some of them, they just want the systems to remain the way they have been.
Mm-hmm.
I remember when I joined the county government, someone actually came to me and told me on my face, "Now you have joined the county government, don't even try change the system."
Mm-hmm.
Yes, because
you adapt to what they do.
Yeah, there's nothing that is going to happen here.
Mm-hmm.
And it's actually true. Yeah, because you fight, you want to do the best. You have the best goodwill at heart to do what you have to do.
Mm-hmm.
But some of them just think you're just there to come and take their jobs. Whereas
so how do you deal with that?
It's because
being in a
point,
space where you feel like I can change a couple of things here, I can be creative in a certain way to improve in one way or the other.
Yeah.
But I'm here suppressed because, you know, it's the system and I have to comply. So how do you deal with that?
It triggers a point, you just have to walk aside, walk out, and deal with your mental whatevers and do you. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
When the time they realize that actually that nothing has happened because mm-hmm. of what is happening. Unasema tu ni sawa.
Okay. So as we wind up, looking back, what made you so determined and patient? Because I'm so sure for probably even a deal to go through, you know, it's a long bureaucracy.
It is.
So what made you so determined and patient?
One, because of the situation that we had
back at home,
mm-hmm. going back to yes. Shags, and yes. now we're in Nairobi and all that. That was one. Mm-hmm. Two, mm-hmm. because my mom used to really work hard. So I used to look at this lady when I was young, mm-hmm. and I used to be like, I want to be like her. Mm-hmm. I want to be like her. I mean, I have my mind, I have my hands, I have my legs. Mm-hmm. Let me do what I can do mm-hmm. to also assist other people. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right. And kwa sababu umeshika mamilioni hivi kadhaa.
Hakuna mamilioni nimeshika wewe.
Cherchomo. Kero na kukuja. How can people find you across all the social media handles?
Ashley Murugi.
As simple as that. Okay.
I use my brand name, oh, Ashley Murugi.
Sawa. Yeah. Thank you very much, Ashley, for creating time to be with us.
Yeah,
welcome. So we'll keep this conversation going. If you want to keep this conversation going, make sure you follow Ashley Murugi across all her social media handles. She is a PR and communication consultant. So make sure you stay tuned. We have so much coming your way. We are coming back with Ram to just sample some of your comments pale on our social media handles. Remember, the pages are at Y254 channel across all our social media handles. The hashtag to use is #Y in the morning at Michelle Shira. You can find me across all my social. We'll be right back.